welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe. And Lee, we live in South Florida.
You think?
It has some problems, though, doesn't it?
Only this time of year, really.
Not always paradise. And you're going to tell us something about hurricanes.
Yes, I will. Hurricane season, we're here, and we have to deal with it. And it's a reality through November. And, you know, it's a good thing to go online and research some sites where you can learn about hurricane preparedness.
I have all of my tracking sites ready.
Good. Good. I know some people do it compulsively.
Yes.
Are you one of those people?
Yes.
And, you know, we're studying in our class about hurricanes as well. So I was doing some research online, and I found National Geographic online, and they have some they have great tools.
Oh,
they have really some
awesome
great tools.
Awesome site.
And one of the things that I found was a great site, a great tool where you can do lots of research on hurricanes, and there's even a hurricane simulator. So if you take a look here, you get to it from environment.nationalgeographic.com.
Okay, it's a little long, isn't it?
It is, and it gets even longer, so I'm going to show you how to navigate to it.
Okay,
once you're at this site, over here to the right where it says Environment Topics, you're going to scroll down just a little bit here to Forces of Nature.
Okay.
And click on that, and then you'll see that the page that will load will give you, bring you to some choices here. You've got tornadoes, volcanoes, hurricanes, and earthquakes.
Ooh.
So we're going to jump over here to hurricanes, and there's lots of information here. You've got what is a hurricane and some basic information here.
Okay.
You can also jump over here to exploring an actual hurricane with some information over here, and this I really like a lot. When you click on next, it takes you actually inside a hurricane.
Oh, wow.
Okay, now watch this. This is just beautiful. And it really gives kids or anybody a real in-depth look inside, you know, a cross-section of a hurricane.
This is awesome.
Yeah, so, you know, it shows them the eye. And, it's, you know, it's hard for kids to understand that the eye is the fastest moving part of the hurricane. Kind of like what I explained to my kids was, you know, when they're playing with the jump rope outside and they're whipping it around so that they can, you know, their friends can jump on the outside, how the inside is going much faster. So I kind of gave them that little simulation for them to understand. But this really brings it closer to them so that they can see how
you
that's going.
Not just for kids. I mean, everybody in South Florida, and you know what, forget South Florida. A lot of our neighboring states all the way over to Texas and up the East Coast have been hit by hurricanes. This is very fascinating.
Yeah, it is. And over here, you can explore a 3D version. If you click over here, it'll take you, it'll move it for you. You can look over here and spin it around. There you go.
Okay, I'm getting dizzy.
Here's some different characteristics, and you can actually change the intensity of the hurricane here. So you can move it to a Category 2 and Category 3.
And they show you little pictures in the corner of the potential damage.
That's right. That's right, exactly. Let's move it up to a Category 5.
Something
so you can
we
see
don't
what
like
happens
to see.
Here with that.
Look at the effect on the water, too.
Here's the effects of a hurricane, and then you have some videos here as well, and some vulnerable beach property as well. Here's some hurricane prediction tools, and you can see that the hurricane trackers, the planes that would fly actually into the hurricanes.
That would be
and
a fun
this,
ride.
This is a great tool for the kids to create their own hurricanes. And what you do here is you pick a starting point. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and pick this one right here. And then you create the temperature, the humidity, and the pressure. So if we were to leave it as it is, say for cold and the humidity low and the pressure at high, what do you think will happen?
Not much.
Probably not much. So let's see what happens. If we check the conditions, we get a message that says, hey, a hurricane can form if it's too cold. So let's go ahead and adjust that. Let's go ahead and bring the pressure down to warm. I'm sorry, the temperature down to warm and the humidity high.
And
let's make the air pressure low and see what happens. There we go.
Oh.
And we've actually created a Category 4 hurricane, and the danger would be extreme structural damage.
Oh. So this is a really cool site. And
yeah.
it's dealing with a lot of water implements because it's, I mean, face it, hurricanes mostly water and wind. And speaking of water and wind, I've got a site here that is actually done by NOAA, N-O-A-A, and it's I'm supposed to switch the computer, and it's not working for me, naturally. I'll get it in a minute. There we go. The maritime section of NOAA.gov. So we go in there, and you can see the URL up here. It's a little tricky to see up at the top. But it's Marine Life, NOAA.gov. And when you get there, you see download the pictures right here. And it's a whole section on a photo gallery of all kinds of pictures related to marine life.
Nice.
Just really.
Now, you can use these for anything you want. Are they offering them copyright free?
These are out there for you to use. And they've got a search in here for you, too. Like if you want to look at a fish, we can just go in there, and all these pictures
are
going to be fish.
Wow, these are beautiful.
They're
now,
very
look at these options. You can choose images for the web, images for print, and images for video. Does that have to do with the quality of the image or the copyright permissions? Do you know?
It's probably more to do with the quality, because images for the web are going to be lower resolution. Print has to be very high. And video, well, that's just going to be video. But you've got categories here. Look at this.
Just not interrupting you for a second, but I'm looking at the user rights on these pictures here. And are you ready for this? Permission for use, any and all users, public domain.
Nice.
In perpetuity.
Nice.
So what's this mean? What's this mean for teachers? What this means for teachers is here's a group, a categories of photos that can be downloaded for digital storytelling. This can be a jump-off point for research in the area, whether it's marine biology or geography or sociology or history. You can use these pictures, challenge the kids, gather some pictures together, make a story, put it together, do some research. Perfect site, and Lee, guess what?
What?
They're free.
Free is good.
And of course, we want to show our kids how to cite the source and always reference back.
Exactly.
So we've got some good things. That's awesome.
It gives you really neat information about each of the fish, too. So it's not just about the picture. There's education happening there as well.
I love that. That's really
nice.
This
is a nice site.
Beautiful. So you can throw these into, you can put one on a blog. You can put one into any kind of digital story, anything online. You can print them out and use them as story prompts. So these are really beautiful.
This is a TIFF.
Now, Frank didn't mention this. Frank, I'm wondering if you can also modify the image. And if we have the rights to do that, you probably didn't say that, but...
Here we are.
Oh, okay, on the
usage rights.
Because that's always an interesting thing to do, to allow kids to do as well, to unlimited uses.
Unlimited uses.
And forever. Okay. So this is a
perpetuity.
Really, really nice site.
Awesome.
Great resource for photographs, and the photographs are spectacular.
They are.
And it's not just photographs. That's another thing I really like. Oh, there's the download button. That's
also
a big file.
These are high-quality images. This one particular one I'm looking on, kelp. 1.9 megabytes. That's a pretty good size picture.
That is.
Nice.
So we're talking 15 by 1500 by 2000 resolution.
Great. So if you want to print something out, that would really give you a great quality print.
And if you used them as a digital photo in a PowerPoint or something else, that'd
be
good
really
quality.
Have a nice quality right there.
Now, see, I've pulled up one now that's a video preview, and we can do. Whoops. Let's see. Video content. But you can look at the videos on here. You can download them. You could put them into a presentation.
Awesome.
A lot of nice things to do.
Very nice. So you know, and one of my favorite things to do is to download videos, have kids do some research, and then take the audio out and have the kids do a voiceover.
Oh, that's
and
nice.
If the usage rights is unlimited, then there's no reason why you can't do that with this.
Okay. So we're going to be right back, and Kim and I are going to be talking about some online applications that you can use like Office. So don't go anywhere.